There are times when it's extremely useful to figure out the underlying structure of a data set. Having access to the most important data features gives you a lot of flexibility when you start applying labels. Autoencoders are an important family of neural networks that are well suited for this task. Let's take a look. In a previous video, we looked at the restricted Boltzmann machine, which is a very popular example of an autoencoder. But there are other types of autoencoders like denoising and contractive, just to name a few. Just like an RBM, an autoencoder is a neural net that takes a set of typically unlabeled inputs and, after encoding them, tries to reconstruct them as accurately as possible. As a result of this, the net must decide which of the data features are the most important, essentially acting as a feature extraction engine. Autoencoders are typically very shallow and are usually comprised of an input layer, an output layer, and a hidden layer. An RBM is an example of an autoencoder with only two layers. Here's a forward pass that ends with a reconstruction of the input. There are two steps, the encoding and the decoding. Typically, the same weights that are used to encode a feature in the hidden layer are used to reconstruct an image in the output layer. Autoencoders are trained with backpropagation using a metric called loss. As opposed to cost, loss measures the amount of information that was lost when the net tried to reconstruct the input. A net with a small loss value would produce reconstructions that look very similar to the originals. Not all of these nets are shallow. In fact, deep autoencoders are extremely useful tools for dimensionality reduction. Consider an image containing a 28 by 28 grid of pixels. A neural net would need to process over 750 input values for just one image. Doing this across millions of images would waste significant amounts of memory and processing time. A deep autoencoder would encode this image into an impressive 30 numbers and still maintain information about the key image features. When decoding the output, the net acts like a two-way translator. In this example, a well-trained net could translate these 30 encoded numbers back into a reconstruction that looks similar to the original image. Certain types of nets also introduce random noise to the encoding-decoding process, which has been shown to improve the robustness of the resulting patterns. Have you ever needed to use an autoencoder to reduce the dimensionality of your data? If so, please comment and share your experiences. Deep autoencoders perform better at dimensionality reduction than their predecessor, principal component analysis, or PCA. Below is a comparison of two-letter codes for news stories of different topics, generated by both a deep autoencoder and a PCA. Labels were added to the picture for illustrative purposes. In the next video, we'll take a look at recursive neural tensor nets, or RNTNs.